So when we get to the boat, we can either look for that special chisel now, or go exploring for a little while. I'm happy with whatever you want to do.
That alchemist would need it finding.
Going towards the statues of the oarsmen, then thread past between them.
Mimir, you never did tell me why Freya spit in your face.
Well, she blames me in large measure for her present circumstances, and not totally without reason. It all goes back to the long war between the Aesir and Vanir. Prior to that, wars for the Aesir were easily won, but the Vanir had proved their equal and exacted devastating damage. And we'll pick this up later.
Found anything good in Fafnir's storeroom? Like, maybe a whetstone?
I wish Mom were here. What is this place?
Could it be? The Eight Thrones.
Stop being coy, Ed. Do you know this place or not?
I'm Mimir, the smartest man alive. I know many things.
Well, whatever this place is, it looks important.
There is little of that.
Found anything good in Fafnir's storeroom? Like, maybe a whetstone?
Good! Keep it up!
Hit ya!
Nightmares, ugh! What awful pests!
Yes, sir. Hey, it's another treasure map. I can read what this says now, but it's a name. Air! Whoa! The name made it light up!
It's the name of one of the Valkyries. That's quite curious.
the mirror. The last mirror in a boat, and they just started the story. What did you want to tell me about the Long War?
Both sides suffered tremendous losses. And for many of us, quite frankly, war was simply no fun anymore. But a rather senseless waste of precious life. Wouldn't you agree, brother? Precisely. Enough was enough. And at last, Odin's most brilliant advisor became determined to find a more enlightened path. He set about to broker a peace between the gods. It took some convincing, but ultimately Odin was persuaded to marry his deadliest enemy, a certain Vanir goddess, legendary not only for her fertile beauty, but her genius and the very Vanir magic that Odin had long aspired to master.
Freya married Odin?
Or I can just tell you the story later.
Ah, good. The special chisel is ahead, past this gate.
Here we go!
I see improvement.
You who walks among the living, my beloved Gulvig calls to me. She yearns for peace, yet her remains lie in pieces. I beg of you, make my Gulvig whole again.
You want us to collect her bones? Gross.
Gulvig's Sather magic knows no bounds. She can reunite you with those you've lost.
Really? How?
Boy,
I can smell your grief, child. Rest assured, her magic is strong enough to create bridges between life and death, if only for a short while.
Boy, we are leaving.
They've taken three of Sweet Gulvig's bones and spread them across the lake. Bring me her bones, child. Gulvig will reward you.
Father, maybe we should look for those bones.
Why?
Didn't you hear him? We could talk to Mom again. If we keep an eye out while we...
Look if you wish, boy. I will not be distracted by this fool's errand. This chisel we seek, what is it?
I'm glad you asked, actually. I have just the story for you. There was a giant once named Thamur. A very giant giant. Who, despite his mountainous size, was without question the greatest stonemason this world had ever seen. Proud Thamur hoped to one day pass his vast knowledge onto his son. But young Hrimthur had the heart of a warrior. Perhaps the father had too much fear in him, or the son too little. Either way, a quarrel of theirs spiraled out of control, and the overworked stonemason, boom, struck his son. Hrimthur ran off into the night. Feeling shame and regret, Thamur chased after his son. But in his emotional state, soon found himself wandering Midgard, lost and alone. Sadly, he caught the eye of the one person he didn't want to meet alone that night. So far from home. Thor.
And what happened next?
You'll see. Thamur fell, he crushed a charming place famed for worshipping the Vanir god Njord. Thor always took credit for planning that one. The truth is, the sweaty ball bag just got lucky.
A wolver!
A dangerous beast. We will take him down together.
Of one, yes. A very, very giant chisel.
That big crystal on the giant's ring looks promising. Darn. That didn't seem to do anything.
Thamur was a frost giant. When he died, his final breath froze everything.
This is locked up good.
Find the tip of that chisel. That's the magic we need.
Apostles. Well, what's the plan? And I'll find Light Crystal.
Come on.
two make quite a formidable duo.
Atreus, to me.
I'm coming.
Well, here's the base for the crystal we saw. But how do we get it down?
Hey, harden the world tree sap.
That's handy. That did it.
What does it say?
To Njord, we offer back the seas back.
Ah, yes. It was believed that Njord calmed the winds and seas for the fishermen. For that, they loved and worshipped him here.
How are we getting down there?
I have a plan.
You do?
Do not act so surprised.
Oh, no offense, brother, but I don't even think Thor with Mjolnir in hand could get through that much ice.
Then Thor is a fool.
This should be entertaining.
Boy.
Right.
Ah!
Crystals, up ahead.
On your mark.
Wow, that was something, that fight. Here, catch. Well, that was a waste of a perfectly good hour.
How were you not seen? There is nowhere here to hide.
Oh, that. It's a little trick my people can pull. A special way of not being seen.
You can be invisible?
More like I can step into the realm between realms. And your mind doesn't understand what it's seeing, so it sees nothing at all. That's how we avoid ever having to actually use the weapons we craft. It doesn't seem to work on dragons, though.
Your brother wanted to know if you're getting enough to eat. I guess I could tell him you are.
Brock was asking about me?
Was there meat on his breath?
You let him touch this again. Come on, then.
So that's how Brock was in the temple right after the water drop. He stepped between realms.
Okay, now, shush. I need complete silence for this. There you go.
Let's get to it. That looks amazing. Until we meet again, my friends. Make sure you watch each other's backs in the storeroom. Wouldn't want to lose my loyal customers. My shop's right here!
We heading into that building?
Yes.
You think there's something inside that'll help us break the ice and get to the chisel tip?
No.
I'll keep thinking.
I'm ready.
fan!
Quiet!
Lemire, you knew this place? Before?
I came here on a diplomatic mission once, trying to broker a peace between Asgard and Vanaheim. That war. So many lives lost. What I didn't know was Thor had already gone on a killing spree of giants.
What did the giants have to do with the war between the gods?
Nothing at all, lad. That's the tragedy of it. They took no side in that madness. But Odin's paranoia is surpassed only by Thor's lust for blood.
Thank you. Another crystal. Just give the word.
Yuma!
Huh. What now? Ooh, you got most of it.
Well, a stealthy plan it is not.
Now we must free the other strap.
We do?
Why are we going up when what we need is all the way down there?
Think.
Well, the chisel tip is under thick layers of ice, so melting it won't work.
Correct.
There weren't any shattered crystals nearby for me to shoot, so that's not an option.
Correct.
That just leaves smashing the ice. We need something ridiculously heavy to... Oh, I get it now.
Good.
How are we going to turn the hammer so it lands near the chisel tip?
Not possible. We cut it free, write it down, and figure out what comes next after.
So your plan involves a whole bunch of luck, then?
You are welcome to suggest a different one.
What now?
Hold tight.
Such a plan seems ill-advised.
Quiet. Jump!
Excellent work. It only fell a little ways.
There's a sand hole, but how do we get to it?
Cannot. What does it say?
When time itself is disarrayed, the forward path is retrograde. Retrograde? It's backwards?
Those symbols. The seasons?
Yeah, but the order's all jumbled. Shouldn't it be winter, spring, summer, autumn?
Why start with winter?
Some song I used to sing.
I know that one. Winter, that...
Quiet, head.
Doesn't like music either. Got it.
Write it.
House. Sulamar. Bar. Veteran. Yes!
Atreus, that word.
Thola. It means endure.
Try it.
Thola.
Well done, lad.
Write it again.
Thola. Horizon! The energy's lifting the platform.
Keep writing.
Thola. Thola. Thola.
Head. How is this possible?
Maggie, yes?
Temporal magic.
Dangerous stuff the High Vanir gods used to play around with. The ability to freeze time. Happened to be a favorite of Njord himself, in fact.
Used to? Why did they stop?
Well, turns out stopping time keeps the sun and moon from streaking across the sky. Unfortunately, it does not stop the wolves that chase them. Always looking to sink their teeth in. After that, they decided it was best to leave time alone.
Before the floor collapses.
Run!
jump! You did well.
Thanks.
The boy.
Just having a little fun, you big grump.
Well, there it is. How are we going to get it free?
A push.
But
trust me. Ready. Dig in and push with everything.
Yes, sir. How do we get down?
We jump.
Really?
Come. Do not panic.
Why would I panic?
I have you!
You're cracked, you know that?
Well. Good. We should keep moving.
Credit. He has a talent for destroying things.
Remember that, Head.
Never leaves my mind.
Those were the guys we saw with Baldur. His nephews?
Aye. Magni and Modi. The sons of Thor.
Mother always said the Aesir were the worst of gods, and Thor was the worst of the Aesir. Guess he's a terrible father, too.
They are no longer children. They have no excuse.
Will Sindri be okay?
I'll never even see him. Ah, the great dining hall. Envy of all Midgard. Funny, I remember there being a massive candelabrum. Really livened up the place. You just can't help but break things, can you?
Ah!
serves, the Jarl's throne was just on the other side of that wall of ice.
Something ahead.
See you, lad.
He's fine.
Thought it best to vanish when Thor's idiot sons showed up.
Those men, what do you know of them?
First, they're not men, they're gods. Well, demigods. Anyway, let's see. Thor's their dad, different moms, sordid story that one. Baldur's their uncle, Odin, dear old grandpa. Oh, and a sister named...
Weapons. How do they fight?
Oh, of course. Magni's strong. Really strong. Carries a huge sword hardened by cyclonic thunder. And Modi? Ugh. I'd sooner lick a rat than shake that dung heap's hand. His mace and shields are just a cheap knockoff of my elegant work on their dad's hammer. Best to follow my lead and avoid, but who am I talking to? Sometimes the best purchase is the one we don't make.
Would you focus on your dad? You quit that shit. I mean it.
Hurry, brother. We may get a piece of the chisel and be gone before they even notice. Uh-oh.
Yeah. Boy. Surrender. The old father demands it. No. This fight is mine, boy. Go!
And where do you think you're going? Oh no, brother! The little freak's got a bow. What are we gonna do? So much more! Don't tell me!
Last time we played sexual.
Oh, this is George, an old man. A newborn lad.
I'll take a small one.
Why do you hunt us? What does Odin want?
Don't know.
Don't care. Come here, half-breed. You're done holding at his hand.
Shut up! Don't call me that!
Calm yourself, boy.
We're coming for you!
Yeah!
Moving a bit slow!
Gonna drag your carcass to us!
Stay behind me, boy. Why do you hunt us? What does Odin want?
Don't know.
Don't care. Come here, hungry. You don't know who that is.
Shut up! Don't call me that!
Can't believe you've lasted this long. Those skinny little arms can barely keep up.
I said shut up!
Calm yourself, boy.
Looks like they need an advice.
Oh, I'm more than happy to teach you.
I'll take the run.
Shut it out! Focus!
Should have never come out.
Don't think we've forgotten about you. Me all to yourself.
Yeah! Oh, I'll try to break all your faces.
No, don't get up.
You don't look too good.
To rile you up.
Idiots!
Slashed! The sons of Thor are welcome to try.
Head!
Sorry, overstepped you.
Over here, freak.
Come
on,
hell
of a fight! Yeah! We're coming for you! Over here, freak! It's a little rough one!
Well, that's a fine mess!
I'll take the big one. There's a little run for his mom.
Loading!
Stop it!
Boy, stay focused.
Yeah!
vision. You have no idea what... You son of a bitch!
Oh, no!
Sickness. Fever has returned.
No! It hasn't.
Boy!
The coffin, the blood. The boy's sick, he needs Freya.
No!
Steady.
I'll be all right.
There you go, lad.
I'm fine, see?
We should keep an eye on him. With that, we can carve the travel rune to Jotunheim. Get you where you need to go. Oh, incidentally, old...